الله واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون واعلموا أن الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله. My dear believers, it is indeed important for us to remind one another to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I advise you and myself to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be always conscious of the fact that everything we do, everything we say, we are answerable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We will definitely be returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like those before us, who were wealthier and healthier, more powerful, more recognized, have already returned to Allah. In a similar way, we too have to return to Allah. So prepare for that day. You and I know that 5 times a day we are called in a certain direction. And the caller reminds us because it is that prescription from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the caller to call out 5 times a day, even though we know our duty towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no place on earth whereby your duty is known, what is required of known, and every single time you have to do it, you are reminded again in a loud way, and it doesn't happen for anything besides Salah. It is the only action, the only work, if I can call it, although it was not actually work, the only action, let's say, act of worship, where every single day, so many times a day, we are called towards it. Have you ever thought why? Why repeat it so many times? It's enough to tell me once, twice in my life that you listen, you need to pray 5 times a day, and that's it. And I'm supposed to be human enough. We would get irritated if someone kept telling us every day, you got to go to school at 7 o'clock, you got to go to school at 7 o'clock, and repeat it at once, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. Repeat it, for example, the azan, twice, you hear, come to the prayer. And twice you hear it again, and what is dhunan is zakama. Just before the prayer, come to the prayer. Wasn't it enough for Allah to just put it in Quran? Wa aqimu salata wa atu zakah. Wasn't it enough for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to just inform us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed upon 5 prayers every day and night? The find that cycle. But Allah says, no, we want you to call out for this prayer every single time. In the Arabic language, one of the reasons, yaqamat al-hujja alayk, for there to be evidence against you on the day of judgment. Did you hear the call? Yes, I did. Well, if you did, why didn't you read Salah? Why didn't you fulfill that prayer? We told you, not only did we say, come to prayer. We told you, what would you achieve through that prayer? Hayya ala salah. That means come to prayer. But you hear immediately after that, hayya ala falah. Come to success. Every one of us, young and old, male and female, looking for success. There's no success beyond that which Allah has promised you. You can never be truly successful if you have disconnected from your 5 salah. The find that cycle. Turn to Allah. Read 5 salah a day. A Muslim and doesn't do salah? Allahu Akbar. How can that be? My brothers and sisters, if you are at 1 in the past and now you are at 2, it's a big improvement. But it is not its ladid. We have to be continue because as Muslimin, we have 5 salawatin fi kulli yawmin wa layla. We have 5 prayers every day and night. You know, we word it differently. When we speak to the younger people, sometimes we tell them, you need a key to enter. For example, let's say paradise. You want to enter paradise, you need a key. You want to enter this door, you need a key. Without key, you are not able to enter the door. Just like, if I want to call you, I need your phone number, brother. If I had 1 error in the whole phone number, I will not get through to you, you see. So, if I want to enter into paradise, I need to read 5 salah. That is the figure, that is the number of keys on the key. If one is missing, what happened? Take it, try it, put it in, it won't open your door. But so many dirty, one is missing? Against your laziness. Oh my, against the coziness of a bed. Again, what you are doing in mall, or at workplace or enjoying with your family, stop everything at a time of salah and quickly fulfill in salah. Imagine I'm saying quickly, whereas by right, it's not supposed to be quickly. And even if you have done it in the midst of your work and you have fulfilled that salah, come with me. Wallahi, that may just be means entry into paradise. You know, we follow Islam where it is easier for us only. Well, we need to do better than that. That means, where it is easy, Alhamdulillah. Where it is difficult, we still want to try. We still want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, I got to release something which shows a real character. Lifting weights, you know weights? Which have heavy weight, I think, maybe 60 or 70 kilos. And he is lifting weight. Which you think is strong? See here, the question is, you think you are powerful, you are strong? Obviously, the young people of today, they want to become a big muscles and they want to be seen and they want to be felt. When they greet you, you just go to say, wa alaikum assalam. You cannot look at them anymore in the way that we used to in the past. No, big man, you get to look at him carefully. So it says, you think you're powerful? You can lift your blanket up for Salatul Fajr, then you'll be strong. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, you think you're powerful? You're strong? You can lift. You want to lift? Lift your blanket up for Salatul Fajr and Tahajjud, then you'll be strong. That is heavy title. Allahu Akbar. My brothers and sisters, I thought it was a very good message. Because today, the message of Deen needs to be put forth to our children and ourselves. In a way that we look at it and we really think, wallahi, it is correct. A powerful person is not the one who can lift 120 kg with his one hand or with his little finger. Subhanallah, no, it isn't. A powerful person is the one who can lift his blanket up for Salatul Fajr and Tahajjud. He is strong. He is success in his life. تَتَجَافَ جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا. In Surah Sajd, Allah says, speak about these powerful beliefs. And Allah says, they are ones whose sides are refused to actually lay down on the bed, on this bed. They move themselves on this bed, the bedding, in order to stand up in prayer for the Almighty at night, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fearing Him and having hope in His mercy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who understand that salah is actually a gift. And may He make us from those who fulfill salah correctly. And may He make us from those who encourage our family as well to fulfill salah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. Subhanallah bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-azim. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
ಜಜಾಕಲ್ಲಾಹ್ ಖೈರ್. ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು ಉಮೇರ್ ಹಸನ್, ಇವರು ಹತ್ತನೇ ತರಗತಿಯ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಯಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ.